Mr. Samuels, you're absolutely wrong about how the female body is supposed to be built. Let's get it. Hi, this is Julien here, taking a fair out of fitness and helping you be the best you. Recently, Kevin Samuels was on his streaming on Instagram Live, and I'll give you a link to it to see exactly what it is that I'm talking about. But Kevin Samuels was talking about the things of how to determine a woman's sexual viability in the marketplace of dating and marriage and things of that nature, right? And while I don't disagree with the high majority of what he was actually saying, the part that I do disagree with is the standard of beauty being that you have to meet your BMI, meaning that if you're 5'4" tall, you must be 120 pounds rock solid or else you're considered unfit. While I completely disagree with that for several reasons. Number one, BMI is an antiquated system to determine one's health. As a matter of fact, what most people don't know is that the BMI is actually a calculation created by insurance companies to determine whether or not you are most viable financially to their company, meaning that you are the most profitable. So in that regards, while there is some correlation to BMI with health risk, the truth is that BMI does not tell the whole entire story as to what a woman in this particular case actually is, because the true standard of what fitness really is, and like I said, Kevin Samuels did not say anything wrong about people needing to be fit. I 100% agree with that. However, the other half of it is that you are not necessarily out of shape because of the fact that you don't meet the BMI, because the real standard is body fat to body mass, right? So body fat to body mass is in fact the standard. So when you do have that standard, if you meet that standard, then your quote unquote dating viability should be what Mr. Samuels determines that to be. However, I don't want women to go out of their way trying to achieve a body fitness that is not exactly meant for them. Because ultimately, your body is your body. Genetics plays a role. You as a female might be carrying the genes of a massive individual who needs to be perpetrated on to further along in society. Obviously, evolution may play a role in all of this because of the fact that it may or may not be necessary in the future to be so large. But the fact is that your genetics does dictate how much muscle mass you actually do increase. So therefore, because of those factors, you must simply go by your muscle mass as opposed to your body fat percentage. Women over the age of 18, but under the age of 40, must be between the body fat percentage of 18% to 24% in order to be considered fit and healthy. Every decade after that, you can add about 2 to 3 more percentage points on there every decade after that because of visceral fat being incorporated around your organs. However, I am not giving people an excuse to be fat. I am giving people the leeway to be large, because being fat and being large is two completely different things. And I want to make sure that you guys understand that, so that way you don't go out of your way breaking your necks trying to achieve a level of fitness that is not actually meant for you. Now, in terms of dating and viability and all that stuff, I'm gonna leave that to Mr. Samuels. But on this fitness side, I totally wholeheartedly agree with him when he says invest in a personal trainer, invest in your fitness, because all of that money that people are spending to quote unquote get their face made up and buying eyelashes and fake hair and all this other stuff, it is not necessary if you absolutely take care of your physical from top to bottom. Now, if in fact that you do want to be the best you, I have no problems with giving you the advice, giving you the help, and giving you the tips that is necessary for you to do so. So if you do want to get that information, hit me on the comment section, subscribe to me on YouTube, follow me on Facebook and Instagram, and have a nice day, and be the best you.